Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And I knew this was going to happen.
They tried this before, haven't they?
Yeah, so Transformers, for those of you who don't know, the license was taken from IDW and it was given to Skybound at Image. And they've rebooted the Transformers and G.I. Joe comic book universes to great acclaim and good sales. That doesn't happen in modern comics very often, right? But I knew as soon as they said they're taking it from IDW that all the IDW stands were going to be furious, because IDW is notorious for putting the trans and Transformers and gender ideology and all that with a cartoon or with a comic book that's just about, you know, robots turning into cars. They have a certain fandom at IDW, and they're getting pissed off now, apparently, that Arcee and Alita 1 actually look like females in the new comics. What?
I think it looks good, personally.
I'm actually going to pick these up.
Sketchier than, you know, I'm used to, but it looks more like kind of what you used to do with comics. You used to make them very sketchy.
Yeah,
I
did.
And I kind of like it.
Well, I got tired of, like, having to draw the ruler to do Transformers.
Reminds me of you.
Well, there you go. And, yeah.
I'm hearts.
So we're going to talk about this because, you know, I knew this was going to happen because we've talked about before the drama around Windblade, that there was somebody that was associated with IDW trying to get them to cancel the Japanese Windblade figure.
That was almost 4 years ago. Gosh.
Yeah.
What happened? It seems like it was 2020, like 2 years ago at the latest.
2020 never ended is what happened. That was the problem.
2020 ends like 2022.
Yeah. So they were trying to get this canceled. There are all kinds of articles written out there about how IDW is LGBTQ plus friendly, that they're, you know, having Transformers.
They were Transformers
having LGBTQ plus relationships. They are robots that turn into cars. In fact, in the Marvel comics, they didn't even have gender, and they flat out said they didn't have gender because one of the pretenders, I think it was Cloudburst, the one issue where there was a female alien hitting on him. And he's like, yeah, hey, guess what? I don't have a dick because I'm not a dude. I'm actually just a robot that turns into a spaceship.
So you think that the non-gendered thing would be what it's in now?
You would think. Well, okay, because they did the non-binary Transformer in the kids cartoon that nobody watches.
Well, I just keep thinking of that one thing that someone did with a Megatron where he turns into a woman.
Megatrans.
It's like,
oh my god,
tits Megatron.
Oh my god, that is still the best Transformers parody ever. I am shocked it's on YouTube. It was Flash Gets.
If you get
it.
A chance, go watch.
If you haven't, they saw it coming. Basically, what happened?
It was beautiful.
Basically, what happened was somebody at IDW watched that and said, you know what? Let's do that, but let's do it for real in the comics. And the comic sales fell off a cliff, and the license got sent over to Skybound. So let's talk about this. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. You get woohoo if you do.
Woohoo.
Go out to shopclownfish.com. You can pick up a copy. We don't have Transformers comics, but you can pick up a copy of Crimson Wren and previously on Clownfish TV.
Ironically, you did do some Transformers comics, but...
I did a couple of pages for IDW before they got stupid. And I actually tried out for the regular title and I didn't get it. And I talked to the publisher at the time who wrote me and he said, no, your stuff's really good. He said, because I was trying out for Dreamwave too, and that was like right when they were imploding. So I took those samples and I sent them to IDW when it was announced they got the license. And they said, yeah, your stuff's really good, but it's going to be really hard to color.
It was.
And because I had a lot of detail, a lot of cross-hatching.
If you go out to DeviantArt and look up Neon T, you can see those over there.
Yeah, there were Armada samples. And I was pretty proud of them. We went out and bought all the toys just to, you know, do it. And that was like my dream job, was actually working on Transformers comics.
Not now.
Hell no. I don't want anything to do with it now. And the fandom has changed too.
Neon's a long time Transformers fan.
Huge.
If you read previously on Clownfish TV, that is mentioned.
Yes. It's also mentioned that Megatron and Starscream were watching us in the bedroom, too.
Yeah, that's a horrible
Because we
story.
Had shelves in the bedroom.
They used to watch us.
We had no place else to put, because we were in an apartment at the time, we had no place else to put the
massive amount of Transformers,
which I sold a bunch of them to help put a down payment on our house. But
I also sold ponies, so it wasn't just him.
I know it wasn't just me. We sold our toys, and we put a down payment on a house.
Okay. I'm buying them all back, so yay.
That is true. That's true. So anyway, let's talk about this. I have to give a hat tip to our friend Aaron Sparrow, who said you should gatekeep your fandoms. I'll go back to the original tweet here. Don't harass this person. I want to be very clear.
Oh, yeah.
I'm saying I knew this was going to happen because of all the outrage around Windblade and all the talk about how IDW made all the Transformers gay. Again, they are robots that turn into cars. When you have to put gender ideology into comic books about robots that turn into cars and shit and blow shit up, you done lost. Yeah, I'm just saying.
Why are they mad? They look too female.
Yeah. So this is this person said, I'm gonna be honest. Can they retire the G1 designs of female Transformers? No. In a vacuum, those designs are cute and all, but when you frame them next to their male counterparts, I'm not even gonna sugarcoat it. The designs are straight up sexist.
They're pink.
Because they're, well, they picked the two pink ones, right? They have other female Transformers. Now, I don't know if Windblade is going to be, I haven't read these comics yet. Everybody tells me I have to read them. They said they're really, really good. But I don't know if Windblade is going to be in them because I think she was an IDW creation. I think that Windblade came from IDW and they might be like, yeah, we don't want to use Windblade because that was kind of their thing. But I know that they've been pushing Alita 1 to the forefront lately. Like she has multiple action figures now. I never thought we'd get one Alita 1 action figure. And we've gotten multiple. In fact, I have one sitting over here. I got her for like $7 at Walmart. Nobody wants the pink robots. They could have made the main girlies as blocky as every other G1 male character and then introduced slender, more rounded off characters, regardless of gender identity, later on down the line.
Actually, I was looking at the characters and I was thinking, yeah, they can tell if you, I was like pushing how boxy they were. I was actually thinking, look, they made them like more, all the curves are even squared. And I was actually appreciating how the lines give you the illusion of having them, but they're still straight lines. I was actually thinking that to myself without reading these comments. Like, oh, look how cool they made it. Like, really, they made sure it was really angular, which makes sense. And yeah. Then they're complaining they're rounded, but they're not really.
Not really, because like Arcee, they toned her down. I mean, like I said, there's a big difference between Arcee and the Japanese Windblade, you know, action figure. Right. They have RC figures like this. But the reality is that the people want fembots. They want fembots to look like fembots. But they do have female Transformers that are not as there's some of them that like you didn't even know that they're female.
In RC's
Minerva,
case,
I think, is one.
In RC's case, too, doesn't she still turn into a motorcycle?
I think she, well, depend. I think in this one, if it's G1, she's going to turn into a sports car.
Okay, sports car. Yeah. But even sports car or motorcycle, they're both very sleek. And yes. they do have. Their shapes and they're like a truck for Optimus Prime. It's going to be more boxy than, say, a sports car, which are going to have, you know, nice sleek lines, or a motorcycle or street bike, which is also going to have sleek lines. So it makes sense that so does she, because she reflects that appearance because she's not a fucking boxy truck.
Well, I think they have, I think it was Strongarm was a female character. They had one of my favorite Cybertron characters was Override, and I think she was female too. I didn't watch cartoon much, but the toy was nice. But it was hard to tell who was who. According to Aaron, he did a little digging. He said this person is obviously an IDW fan. I think we're gonna see more of this because they're pissed off that IDW is no longer doing the books, and RC was made trans, like Shockwave forced her to be a female or something. I'm like, well, that's not very PC of you.
I don't understand. I mean, I'm a chicken. It doesn't bother me. But I'm like, they're looking at Barbie. Well, yeah, you know, look at it this way. It might bring other little girls into the line. That might be what they're thinking. Like, you know, hey, this is usually predominantly male. Why don't we try to get girls interested in it too? Because I know there are a lot of girls interested in the movies. Let's try to make, and the shows, a lot of times they have female, you know, humans, usually a woman. So let's you know, get girls into this too. And why does it have to be like STEM isn't just for boys? Why does Transformers have to be just for boys? And maybe by having RC in there, girls are like, oh, I like her, you know?
Well,
but you don't have to do that because this person's going to tell women what they have to like. I don't know if it's a chick or a dude. I have no idea. But
so I think that's Hasbro's thought process, but I'm going to tell you the truth. It ain't working.
Oh, I know it's not because working. I'm thinking that's what they're thinking.
Like, we went to our local Walmart, and they've got a ton of the Transformer 2-packs on clearance. Mm-hmm. And almost all of them have Alita 1 or Arcee in them.
No, of course, Neon grabbed them up immediately.
Yeah, I'm like, I like pink robots. Sure, I like bots with boobs, tit bots. I loved Transor Z back in the day, Mazinger Z. And Aphrodite had missile tits. That was pretty cool. I thought that was cool. But, you know, most little boys, they're going to be like, no, I want a robot that looks like he can kick ass, that turns into a truck or a jet or something. I don't want a pink robot with tits that turns into a sports car. And I can't see some 10-year-old telling his mom, like, hey, mom, I don't want a pink robot with tits that turns into convertible.
But if that's the case, then maybe this person has a point then. Maybe they should take their female robots and make them look more like the male counterparts, and then maybe they would sell more toys. Like, I mean, devil's advocate
I'm
here.
I'm sexy.
Devil's advocate. I'm just saying.
Mega trans.
You guys, if you haven't watched it, go watch it. You don't understand.
I might put that in a thumbnail. I might put Mega Trans in a thumbnail. Oh my God, it's so accurate.
Then to what you're saying, then that point stands. Then their argument maybe stands somewhat in the fact that, why are you making it look really feminine? Because, you know, your target audience isn't going to buy the toys. Maybe you make them look a little bit more like the other Transformers, and then they still won't buy the toys. But you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Devil's advocate.
Well, here's the thing, because Alita 1, actually the toy of Alita 1 that I've got sitting here that was on clearance because they had piles of her, I think it's cool because I like the Alita 1, but they don't make her look like a sexy bot or whatever. She's actually kind of blocky.
But you can still tell it's supposed to be a female.
Yeah. Yeah.
She still has a tiny waist. I mean, honestly, that looks kind of like the drawing, I mean, in some ways.
Yeah, well, they're basing her up. Look, here's the thing. Skybound is trying to get back G1 fans because IDW lost G1 fans. And let's be honest, Hasbro wants to sell toys. And who are they selling toys to? Predominantly, it's G1 Transformer and G.I. Joe fans who buy high-end collectibles.
And they're predominantly male. I mean, there are women. I'm not going to say there aren't, because I know for a fact there are women who collect Transformers and like Transformers. But predominantly, it's a male audience.
Now, will they stay away from the shit that IDW was doing, you know, Cliffjumper and Bumblebee? Or are they going to be a couple?
Wait, what?
I don't know. No, they were like shipping the Transformers, and they were having conversations about gender. And I'm not even kidding. In the IDW comics.
You know why they call me Cliffjumper? Sorry.
I peek and then I just fall off.
Vancouver, Bumblebee. Anyway, show me your stinger, Bumblebee.
Oh, my God. Put it in my tailpipe. I am not going to miss these fans. And again, so the IDW comics were hit or miss. The art was good on a lot of them. But toward the end, it started to get freaking weird. I mean, I noped out years ago, I think after All Hail Megatron. And I was also pissed off that they killed Hunter off, Hunter Onion, Onion. They turned him into a headmaster, and then they ripped them apart. And I was like, what the hell was that? That was just stupid. It was stupid. So I've been out for years, but this might actually get me back because it looks like they're trying to win back G1
fans. When I see that, I just see that they're trying to go with the G1 style. That's all I see.
Yeah, that's it. Because
I mean, I'm not reading anything into it other than they're trying to go with the G1. And if they do another version, they'll make them look different for that version. They usually do.
Yeah. So this is, if you're offended by femininity in American Transformers media, go to Japan, pick up some some of these Japanese model kits, Google kiss players and see where you're at with it, and be like, you know what, I'm okay with Arcee having a couple of curves. That's okay compared to kiss players. That's totally fine. Do you know what kiss player that was? Binal Tech, which was alternators here in the U.S. Well, in Japan they had the alternators line, but they also had a bunch of, I don't know if they were underage girls or what, but it really was pretty like lowly cons, right? And Megatron's got his tongue hanging out in the manga, and the whole kiss players. And they came with little female action figures.
Well, I was just thinking about how I thought the tie being yellow was clever. That's all I was thinking.
I love these. I gotta be honest. They have three or four of them. They have Starscream, they have Megatron, and she's in military
banging
uniform.
Banging tits, Megatron?
Yeah. Kraken tits.
Kraken, is that what it was?
Kraken tits. Yeah.
Kraken. I don't remember.
Kraken pair of tits.
Though.
I've seen it like.
Kraken pair of tits. That's it. God, yes.
That's a Kraken pair of tits. Yeah.
Yes, that's it. So great.
And of course, Starscream would be all that because Starscream's coded gay.
Oh my god, they had
annoying and prissy and backstabbing, and that's not, those aren't good character traits.
No,
that's not the
representation.
It's
honestly a woman. No, sorry.
Starscream is a bitch. He's a whiny little bitch, and that's why he got taken out. But yeah, so there we go, guys. Yeah, it could be worse. Oh, Matt Moylan, little formers. Yeah, it could be worse. There you go. You could have this RC. Is that better? She's barely wearing anything.
Oh, she's all metal, so she's completely covered.
Yeah, well, she's probably got flesh where it counts. Are we gonna wrap this up?
Yeah.
Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later.
Bye.